Hospitals in Metro Manila seeing an increase in non-COVID cases. Health officials say more patients with chronic diseases are seeking medical checkups as the COVID situation in the country improves. As hospitals deal with a surge in non-COVID illnesses, the public is advised to coordinate first with the Health Department's National Patient Navigation and Referral Center.
So ngayon po, na-launch na tayo as the National Patient Navigation and Referral Center. So meaning to say po, hindi na lang po COVID ang hinahandle natin, but we also handle po non-COVID patient. We also expanded po sa telemedicine natin or teleconsultation, and lahat po ng mga medical assistance po na pwede nating i-provide sa community, tayo po ay nagko-coordinate sa proper agencies or offices. Medyo napupuno na po yung mga hospitals natin because of non-COVID cases. Katulad po ng experience natin before na pag bumababa po ang mga COVID cases, medyo tumataas din po yung mga non-COVID cases because dito po nakakapagpakonsulta po yung mga chronic diseases natin or mga uncontrolled po na mga sakit ng tao. So nakakapunta po sila sa mga emergency room.
The town of Uban in Sorsogon preparing for possible evacuation of residents as state seismologists believe Mount Bulusan could erupt again. Our correspondent Jose Carretero now joins us with an update. Jose, what more can you tell us?
Good afternoon, Carmina. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology here in Sorsogon is closely monitoring the activity of Mount Bulusan following an increase in volcanic activity around 11:30 evening. Cebu's resident volcanologist April Dominguiano says they've monitored 145 volcanic quakes starting 11 o'clock last night. CIVOC says an increase in volcanic quakes could lead to a periodic eruption. This morning, Uban Municipal Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office convened the disaster response team and laid down plans should a periodic eruption occur. Trucks that will be used in possible evacuation are now on standby. MDRRMO spokesperson Arian Aguayo says they have already coordinated with the Philippine Army should they need assistance in transporting residents to the evacuation center. The identified evacuation centers have been prepared already, Aguayo adds. It can be recalled that evacuees in last Sunday's phreatic eruption were sent home Wednesday morning after the volcano did not show signs of increasing activity for almost 3 days. Meanwhile, classes in Barangay Anyog and Puting Sapa, which are inside the 5-kilometer extended danger zone, were already suspended. The resorts in Uban, Sorsogon were also temporarily closed starting today. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Jose Carretero there joining us on the line. Take care, Jose, and keep safe. President-elect Marcos receives more courtesy visits, this time from the United Nations envoy and European ambassadors. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us with the details. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. raised the importance of accountability in terms of human rights during his meeting with United Nations Resident Coordinator in the Philippines, Gustavo Gonzalez. Gonzalez told reporters after his courtesy visit on Marcos that the president-elect of the Philippines is very much interested in ensuring a consultation for the nomination of a new commissioner on human rights. He says that Marcos also mentioned the importance of, again, ensuring the high level of accountability when it comes to human rights. Now, Carmina, Gonzalez did not specifically mention the President Rodrigo Duterte's war on drugs that was unleashed since 2016, but the conversation was premised on a 2019 resolution from the United Nations Human Rights Council, which sought a comprehensive report on the human rights situation in the Philippines. If we recall, in 2020, the United Nations Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights released a report that documented the widespread human rights violations and persistent impunity in the country. Gonzalez said that Marcos' statement came after he suggested and after he underscored that the United Nations is committed to continue the gains that was already bad since 2016. He says that there is a need to continue in enhancing accountability in terms of human rights and making sure that new policies to improve the human rights situation in the Philippines is adopted. Carmina, in a separate meeting with Swedish ambassador to the Philippines, Annika Sundberg, Marcos Jr. committed to continue his President Rodrigo Duterte's war on drugs, but with the caveat that he will do this within the framework of the law and with respect for human rights and focus on rehabilitation and socio-economic development. Carmina, the Swedish ambassador, said that this is very much appreciated from her government. This discussion on human rights, Carmina, is quite interesting because, as we all know, Marcos and his family continues to be hounded by human rights abuses committed during the dictatorship of their patriarch, late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. To recall, some 11,000 people were identified as victims of rape, mutilation, psychological and emotional abuse, arbitrary detention, and other human rights abuses committed during the martial law in the 1970s. Despite this, Carmina, or rather, even if 11,000 already seems like a huge number, human rights group Amnesty International says some 64,000 other victims who sought reparations from the Marcos family were not included in the list of official claimants here in the Philippines. Carmina, just to add to the discussion, apart from the discussion on human rights, they also tackled issues of climate change and peace in the Bangsamoro region. Carmina, I heard you earlier mentioning that United States Deputy Secretary of State Wendy Sherman mentioned that Marcos will be free to travel to the U.S. without being arrested, despite his standing contempt order from a U.S. court. This was also mentioned partly in his meeting with Gustavo Gonzalez, with Gonzalez saying that the president-elect has begun discussing on preparations for the United Nations General Assembly, which will be held in New York this September. Marcos's camp, however, has yet to respond to queries if the Philippines' 17th president has already accepted the invitation to travel to the United States for the said meeting. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Katrina Domingo there joining us on the line. Take care, Kat. Keep safe.